this is not really working. So. Hi guys, I'm actually starting this vlog so late at night, which is crazy. It's 10:30 p.m. But I'm about to go to Target to do some fall decor shopping, which I'm really excited for. So I was like, I want to obviously bring you guys along for that, and so I figured I would just start the vlog now. I wanted to go late at night, that way it would be a little bit easier to vlog while I was there, because there won't be as many people around, hopefully. I'm pretty shameless with vlogging, but like, still, it can be a little awkward. But I want to say there's gonna be lots more vlog content coming. I know there's like 2 weeks that I really haven't done any vlogging because my computer has been in the shop for 2 weeks, and so I haven't been able to do any editing. And I thought, rather than having like 2 weeks worth of vlogs, which is a lot of footage, just built up and it would go up so much later, I would just take a little break from the vlogging. I vlogged anything that I thought was super fun, which you've already seen by now, but I don't know, I just thought for my everyday life type stuff, it's the same old, so I don't necessarily need to document that while I didn't have a way to edit it. But I'm getting my laptop back tomorrow, hopefully. I called them today and they said that they got the part in today, so it should be ready tomorrow. And I hope that this solves my problem with my laptop, because it's been having a lot of problems lately. Okay, anyway, 10:30 at night and we are venturing out to Target. I'm pretty tired, not gonna lie, but it's a Friday night, like I can go to Target. Let's get crazy.
So much Halloween candy. Whoa, this is dangerous for a candy addict like me. Bubble tape. I forgot about bubble tape. So good. I never know how to use these things. Nailed it. Hello, friend. Okay. Hearth in Hand is the best. I love Chip and Joanna. Look at all of this stuff. This is so cute and so dangerous for me. I don't even need this for anything, but I do. This little thing, don't even know what it's for, but I want it. Look at these pictures. They are so beautiful. Oh, God. I just love all of their stuff. Okay, we're focusing and we need to find some cute fall decor, like this little guy. I'm already in love. These are pretty cute. Let's see. I think that'll look good in my apartment too. It'll match the colors. It's like a pear. Yeah, I guess I don't need a pear. Pumpkin. Oh, it's a candle. Let's smell it. I love smelling candles at Target. Smells like fall. That smells so good. White ginger pumpkin. So good. What about this guy? It's okay.
This is so fun. Oh my gosh, I wish I had somewhere to put this, but I like don't. Look at how fun. More pumpkins. That's pretty cute. A little golden one. I like that. Maybe I should get like a cute blanket or something. Or what's this? It's just like a something to throw on something. This pillow is sort of fun and it's on sale. I mean, it's plain, but it's cute. Let's put that in there for now. And then like pair it up with one of these, or maybe I should get something smaller. Here's some more pillows. This one's sort of cute. Oh, it's like long. What's this? Give thanks. It's nice for fall. Oh, this is cute. A little pumpkin guy. That could be fun. Yeah, like those two will look cute together on my couch. Okay, this is all I have in my cart so far. I didn't find a lot of the stuff that I was sort of looking for. So I'm trying to decide here. I think I'll look at home and see if I already have a fall dish towel. If not, I can come back for that guy. I think I'm gonna ditch this pillow, but keep the little pumpkin guy, and then keep these two pumpkins. So I know this is obviously not a lot, but I have an idea of what I want, and I just didn't really have it here. And some of the stuff was just like sort of priced badly, in my opinion, like just too much for a little tchotchke.
Okay, sirens, like as soon as I start filming. Okay, so not the most successful Target run, to be honest. You know, Targets in Southern California just really don't have the best decor sections. It sort of sucks. Whenever I'm like somewhere else in the world and go to Target, they have the cutest stuff.
Oh, I wish we had a Home Goods nearby.
But I think that will be the move, is going to Home Goods for some cute stuff. Let's see, it says exit this way, okay. Hi guys, I'm home, obviously, and just getting ready for bed. Because it's late, it's past midnight already. But I want to try this face halo thing. It's a non-toxic, reusable, and recyclable makeup remover. Let me show you what it looks like. I actually think it has to be wet, so we'll probably move into the bathroom. But I feel like I've talked to you guys before about how I use so many cotton pads and how I wish that I had a like less harmful way to go about. Oh wow, there's so many of them in here. Okay, so just in one package, three face halos come in there. This is the black one, it also comes in white. Just add water, remove makeup, wash and reuse. I mean, that's pretty easy.
I'm breaking out right now, which is a bummer, but it's definitely because I'm about to start my period. So I discovered this product because I saw Jamie Greenberg use it, who is a celebrity makeup artist and a good friend of mine. She's awesome, you should definitely follow her. But when I was watching her use this, I was amazed at how well it was working. And it's like, I don't get it. Like, it's just a little like fuzzy thing. So I'm very interested for this first swipe. It definitely took it off. Wow, actually like, that's pretty great. You can like see it on there a little bit. Okay. That is like pretty awesome. I mean, wow. Okay, I'm just going to like give it a rinse and then we're gonna try on eye makeup because I feel like that's obviously a little bit trickier. I mean, it definitely pulled my eyeshadow right off. Let's see about mascara. Okay, actually that worked pretty well. I wasn't expecting to like it for my eye makeup. One thing I'll say is you do have to sort of like pull hard on your eye area. So if you're one of those people who is sort of like OCD about that, maybe not the best choice, but from what I can tell, it took my mascara off. It doesn't feel like hard at all. I would say it's probably not my favorite for my eye makeup. I mean, it seems like it did the job, but I don't know, it's just not my favorite. Still, if I could just use one cotton pad a day to take my eye makeup off rather than three or four or however many I need that day, that would be fantastic. I wonder what the longevity of them are, like how long before this is not good to use anymore.
So this says like the proper way to actually clean it is throw it in the washer, like with your darks. And it says that you can wash up to 200 times before replacing. So that's like 200 days, assuming that you only take your makeup off once a day. Okay, so this says also for your eyes so that you don't have to rub, if you just hold the face halo there, just like apply some pressure for 10 to 15 seconds, or this actually says 5 to 10, it should pull it off and then you can like sort of. Cool, that's awesome.
Let's go get our morning coffee.
Okay.
Yum. Thank you. Coffee goes into the fridge so that it will be iced coffee by the time I get back from my workout. Okay, good.
And now I'm off to the gym. I've been back from the gym for almost an hour now, actually. But I came back, I showered, and I had the worst stomach ache leaving the gym. Like, I think I just pushed myself a little too hard on an empty stomach. I really don't like eating before working out because then I find my stomach hurts because it's like too much food, but I guess I actually didn't eat that much yesterday because I wasn't feeling well, so that's probably why. Anyway, but I've just been watching the news, keeping up with all this Kavanaugh stuff. It's not good. It's really not good. But at least we're gonna have an FBI investigation now. Don't know if it'll change anything, but we'll see. It's already 1:30. Oh my gosh, I have so much stuff that I want to get done today, and it's just like, it's really not happening. But I need to start by just eating something. Let's see. Then I'm gonna heat up the leftovers of this like mushroom plate thing I got from Loci. I think that's what it's called. I don't know. I went there last night with some friends before I started vlogging, and I have a little bit left, so I'm gonna heat this up. It's sort of like a sad Chipotle bowl, honestly. I'd much rather Chipotle. Little while later, ate my lunch. I forgot about my coffee, so I'm going to finish drinking that now. And edited a vlog, which is uploading right now. I also got the call that my laptop is officially ready for pickup. I'm very excited about that. That's gonna be awesome. So now what I'm gonna do is sort of tidy up my place a little bit and pull out my decorations box and check out what sort of fall stuff I have already, start to put some of that out, and then figure out if I need or want anything else for my apartment. Let me show you where we're at. What we have so far are these two pumpkins that I got yesterday here. I feel like we need one more sort of taller thing here, but I have a plan for that. I'll tell you in a second. I put this little pumpkin next to my TV, just like I had last year. I changed my sign to say, bring your own booze, like BYOB. I'm sure you guys get it, but thought that was pretty cute. I also have, please ignore this mess just from me getting out my decorations bin, but I have this pumpkin, which I think I'm going to spray paint, which is part of like my plan that I'm about to tell you guys about. And it'll go over onto this table somewhere. Okay, so here's my plan. I'm going to go to the dollar store and just try to find some sort of like tall, skinny vase that will literally cost me a dollar, and then I'm just going to spray paint it. And I was thinking silver, but now I'm feeling like maybe I should go with gold just because all the colors in my apartment are a little bit on the warmer side. And so I just feel like maybe gold would go with the vibe better. I sort of liked silver for Halloween, but yeah, I'm thinking I might change my mind on that. I also would really love to find like some sort of little skull, maybe at the dollar store as well, like a plastic little skull thing that I can spray paint. Okay, I changed into some clothes that I don't want to get messy. And we're gonna attempt this. This should work. I am more concerned about like just not making a mess anywhere in my apartment, because that would be a problem for obvious reasons. And I may die of spray paint poisoning. I don't know if that smell that happens, but we're gonna try this. Here we go. Oof. Here it goes. Just wanna pick this up, confirm. Okay. But this is not really working. So
the paint is just not really sticking to the material of the pumpkin. I think I'm just gonna continue doing coats of this and see if maybe it'll magically fix itself. Let's see.
All right, my pumpkin DIY was sort of a fail. It doesn't look terrible, but it doesn't look great, so it's probably gonna get thrown out.
It is many hours later, and I'm ready to head out to my friend Austin's housewarming. I'll show you what I'm wearing in a sec. Should be super fun. Haven't seen Austin in a while, and Diana will be there because Austin and Diana are dating, so yeah, it'll be great. We are going for a nice comfy look today. Hello. I'm just wearing my XLE sweater, which you guys know I love, and then I'm wearing my usual Zara jeans, my black Steve Madden booties. Are they Steve Madden? Yeah, they are. And then I'm wearing these two little pendant necklaces, coin necklaces type deal. I'm having trouble talking today, apparently. Those are from Shein. My belt is also from Shein. I just thought I'd add a little pop of print with the cheetah belt there. And cheetah belt, cheetah sisters. Oh, I miss the cheetah girls. Anyway, I'm clearly in a mood, I think because I've been inside all day and have had no human contact. So it's time to get out and try to fix all of this. I am at Austin's party. Hey. Very, hello friends.
so many friends. I've been here for a long time and I kept saying, oh, I forgot that I was vlogging, but then I wouldn't vlog. So now I'm finally doing it. There was this guy who was just here. I've never experienced anything like it. I could not understand. He walked in, he stood in the middle of this TV screen where people were playing games and announced his name. I've never met anyone like it. It was a lot. But it's been a great time. He only stayed for 10 minutes, so it's all right. And it's midnight now. We're just having a nice, chill time. Hi, guys. It's actually the next day, but I don't think I ended the vlog last night. I literally came home and got directly into bed, like right away. I was just very tired. I even had plans to go out after that party and ended up just going home instead. Also rocking the Brian Redman merch. Very comfy t-shirts. Gotta rep your friends. But anyway, I'm just here to end this vlog. So thank you guys for watching and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.